What's up, guys? Welcome to another session with Mr. Abdulwahab. This is Hermes Test Prep, and again, we're working on the IGCSE English as a Second Language exam. This is paper two of the May-June 2016 extended paper. This is the second variant of the paper, and we're working on exercise number four, which is the note-taking exercise. In previous videos, we worked on exercises one, two, and three. You could go back and check those exercises. For today, we're going to take a look at this note-taking exercise and how to do it efficiently and rather quickly. So, as usual, you get a text, okay, and on the next page, you get this notebook paper-looking image where you are supposed to put down the notes. So before you begin by reading the text, you need to read the question. So read the following article about special effects artists, okay, and then complete the notes on the opposite page. So this is going to talk to us about special effects artists. Just by looking at the text, I see CG and I know CGI. So those are the people who work on animating characters in movies. You go immediately to the next page just to have an idea of what kinds of information you're looking for, okay? Don't begin by reading the text and then you don't know what the information is or the notes are. And so you read it once and then you go back and you read it twice. Don't try not to do that, okay? So we're going to try to do this in one reading. So you have been asked to give a talk to your class about special effects artists. Prepare some notes to use as the basis of your talk. Make your notes under each heading. So they need information about different types of artists and the main task of each. So we need the name or the job of, or the type of the artist and what he does. Okay, so they gave us one. They filled in one for us. So it's the CG special effects artists and they create characters and sets. So they gave us an example here, which is rather generous of them. And then we need to take a look at what you could do if you want to become a special effects artist. Okay, so we're looking at these two kinds of stuff. And this is, they gave us the format in which we need to write the first information that is required. So we write the type of the artist and then dash and then what the artist does. So let's get to the point, okay? So in films, nothing is impossible. Living, breathing dinosaurs can roam the earth. Humans can rocket to distant galaxies and battle with alien races. This type of cinematic magic is made possible by the hard work of teams of special effects artists. Some of these artists work with computers, while others work in more traditional ways. So let's take a look at the types of artists. In order to create computer-generated CG special effects, artists begin by producing 3D models of characters and sets on a computer. So this is the first input that they wrote here, that the CG special effects artists, they create characters and sets, okay? So they've already done this part for us, okay? They'd already done this part for us. The models are first created as wireframes and that establish the underlying structure of a character or object. Realistic surfaces, skins, and textures are then added. After that, animators are responsible for the movement of characters. Okay, so what animators do is they make the characters move. They're responsible for the movement of the characters. Let's see if they're responsible for something else. Character animation is a slow, painstaking means difficult process that requires incredible attention to detail and a deep understanding of natural human movement and facial expressions. So they also work on facial expressions as well as the movement of the characters. Using mathematical algorithms, animators have developed hair that sways in the virtual breeze and clothing that wrinkles realistically when a character moves. So that's one type of that's the second type of the special effects artists that work on movies. Traditional modelers are still a crucial part of special effects teams. So that's another part. They create, what do? They create miniature versions of large objects, okay? Buildings or entire film sets. Modeling is often associated with old special effects techniques like the miniature spaceships that roar by the camera in the original Star Wars trilogy. Then we have the pyrotechnic effects artists. Are licensed professionals trained in the safety precautions involved in large-scale explosions, fire, bullet shots, and small-scale explosive devices. So they are responsible for the safe precautions taken when applying certain special effects like explosions and fire and bullet shots and so on. In addition to their extensive knowledge of explosives, okay, these artists design firework-like effects that achieve exactly what the director wants. Okay. So that's the third type of artists. Again, they did the first one for us. Then we have a special effects makeup artist. is part modeler, part sculptor, part painter, part chemist, and part beautician. Makeup artists need to learn how to mix different chemicals to make moldable materials, so they mix different chemicals to make moldable materials that are safe for close contact with skin. Okay, so that's one thing. This is because they have to create masks and special effects makeup for humans to use. They also have to know how to use more traditional makeup techniques to blend the real and the artificial. So I'm going to stop right here. I'm going to begin by taking my notes. So they did the first one for me. I'm going to go back up. And the second one we had was animators. And again, they work on the movement of characters and their facial expressions. So those are a couple of things that they work on. So here on the line, okay, again, I'm going to copy exactly as I see in the text. There's no need to capitalize or anything. So animators, okay. And again, as I see it above, I'm going to put a dash after animators, and I'm going to write what they're responsible of. They're responsible for character movement, okay, and facial expressions. Just a few pieces of information are fine. You could mention one of them, so I'm going to put a slash here. Now, the second type that they mentioned in the text was, or actually it's the third type, was the modelers, okay, and they create miniature versions of large objects. So they create miniatures, basically, okay, they're responsible for miniatures. So I'm going to go back down here, I'm going to write modelers, okay, again, dash, okay, and then what they're responsible for. So they create miniatures, okay, they create miniatures. We go back up. And the next type is the pyrotechnic effects artists, okay? The pyrotechnic effects artist. So going back down here, gonna write pyrotechnic effects artists, okay? And comma, what do they do? Again, they do a lot of things. Many things were mentioned. They are trained in the safety precautions involved for explosions. They make sure these safety precautions are taken. Of course, they work with explosive. They do firework type effects. So any one of them would be fine. Again, you're taking notes. You're not transferring most of the information. So they're responsible for safety precautions, we could say, okay, for explosions. That would be quite fine. Finally, the last type mentioned was the makeup artist, okay? And what they do is they create, as they said, they create masks and, special effects makeup. So I'm going to, right, I'm going to keep it quite short. So we have makeup artists, and they're responsible for masks. That's quite enough. Now, what you can do if you want to become a special effects artist. So let's see what are the things that you need to do if you want to become one of those special effects artists. If you'd like to become a special effects artist, the best advice is to absorb all the information you can find. You can search online video sharing sites for free tutorials. You need to search for tutorials to become this type of artist. Then it's time to start playing, okay? Have fun building your own models. So you need to build your own models, either from skins or originals. Play with different molding and sculpture compounds, okay? So you need to experiment with different compounds yourself and learn how to make your own. You need to learn how to make your own compounds that you could use in this, okay? So there's a lot of self-teaching. A degree in special effects isn't absolutely necessary, okay, but I mean, it may be the best way to get experience and basic training in all of these special effects fields. So a degree in special effects doesn't really harm. Many of universities offer training in 3D modeling and computer animation. While studying, you can also watch slow motion recordings of people and animals to see how bones and muscles move as the body subtly shifts weight. It is helpful to study movement by going to ballet performances and taking trips to the zoo. All these are great ways to start your career making magic in the movies. Who knows, one day one of your creations might end up on the big screen. So all of the information we need is actually quite written here clearly. We're just gonna take this information, we're gonna put it down. So if you want to become a special effects artist, the first thing mentioned in the text was that you need to absorb all the information. So absorb, as it's written in the text, absorb information. I'm not gonna comment with my own opinions on this, because again, it's like copying information. It doesn't matter if I agree with it or not. It doesn't matter if I like what's written or not. It's all about taking the information and putting it down there. As they said, you need to watch online tutorials, so watch online tutorials, okay? Another one that I remember was building your own models, being creative with your own models. So I'm gonna write it here, okay? So build or create, okay, own models. Then I also remember the next point, which was the here, play with different molding and sculpture compounds and learn how to make your own. So ex basically experiment or try, okay? So play with molding compounds, see what works, what doesn't work, okay? Or learn how to make compounds, or learn to mix chemicals. That was what's mentioned in the text. And finally, I remember they said a degree, special effects, along with watching slow motion recordings. Any one of those really works. So watch slow motion recordings, okay, or study the movements of animals, or get a degree in special effects, okay, degree in special effects. Any one of those works. So this is the note taking or the note making exercise. As you can see, it's not really hard. You just need to follow the instructions and copy exactly as you see stuff. Don't capitalize words that are not capitalized. Don't minimize letters that shouldn't be minimized. So that's everything for this. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for some more tutorials on the IGCSE ESL exam. See you on the next video.